Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you types of casting in computer network. And I have seen there are few interesting questions that comes regularly based on this topic. So along with theory, I'll give you some practical examples for casting. So that will give you fair enough idea about how many things are there regarding casting in computer network. So basically there are three categories of casting which is happening in computer network. One is unicasting, second is multicasting, and third is broadcasting. If you want to understand that in layman term, then based on name itself, you can understand. See, uni means one, means one-to-one data transmission is happening. So there will be one transmitter and one receiver. That is how unicasting is done inside computer network. When it comes to multicast, then there will be one transmitter and multiple receiver, right? But when it comes to broadcast, then there will be one transmitter and all receivers. But that is not that simple. For that, you need to understand everything along with practical example, right? Like you see, when it comes to multicast, that is very easy. Here, there will be one-to-one message forwarding, right? And using IP of node, we can do unicasting. Let me give you one example. For example, you see, here we are having network A. Here we are having network B. And by this black dots, you can observe nodes are there. Those nodes can be computer, mobile, anything, right? Now let us say this node wants to communicate to this node, then this node will have to forward message with the address, and that address will be there as per IP address of this node, right? So you see what is happening. This node is sending data to this node using IP of this node. So whatever IP which is there with this node, that will be used by this node to forward the message. So one-to-one data transmission is happening, that is referred as unicast, right? Now when it comes to multicast and broadcast, at that time there are few interesting points that you need to note down. Like in broadcast, there are two categories: limited broadcast and direct broadcast. I'll explain you that by practical example, that will give you more clarity. Like you see, here we are having network A. Here we are having network B. In network A, there are some nodes connected by links, you can observe. And in network B, there are some nodes connected by link, you can observe over here. Now, if I say this network A, that is having class A type of network with IP address given over here. You see 90.0.0.0. So this is class A type of address. And this network B, that is having address of 91.0.0.0, right? So these are the IP address of these networks. Now, what is the meaning of limited broadcast? So for example, let us say this node wants to communicate with all the nodes inside this network. Means this node wants to broadcast the message to all the nodes which are there inside network A. So that is referred as limited broadcast. So for that, what this node will do? This node will be broadcasting message by this IP address, which is 255.255.255.255, right? So by this IP address, when this node is sending data, then inside network A, this node will be broadcasting message to all the other nodes which are there inside network A, right? Now, this is what limited broadcast. But what if this node wants to broadcast message inside network B? So that is referred as direct broadcast. But how it will do this? So for that, it has to use IP address of network B. So what it will be doing is, you see, here this node wants to send data to all the nodes, means broadcasting inside network B. In that case, it will be using initial number 91, and after that 91.255.255.255, that address that will be forwarded by this node which will broadcast message inside network B. So when one node wants to broadcast message inside given network, at that time it will be doing limited broadcast, in which it will be using IP address which is 255.255.255.255. But when one node wants to broadcast message inside another network. At a time, it will have to use IP of that network, in which first digit, that is 91, after dot 255.255.255, that IP will be forwarded by this node to this network, and this node is now broadcasting message inside all the nodes, inside this network B with all the nodes, right? That is how limited and direct broadcast is happening. For example, as if one node over here wants to broadcast message inside network A, then what it will have to do? This node will have to use which IP? This 90, then dot 255.255.255. That IP that has to be forwarded over here via this router, and after that the message forwarded by this node will be broadcasted over here inside network A. See, this is how things are happening. So limited broadcast means what? Node will be broadcasting message inside given network, and direct broadcast means what? Here node will be broadcasting message in another network, right? That is how things are there. Now, very interesting thing that you need to understand, that is multicast. Now, initially I have told you, like, multicast means what? One node will be sending data to many node, but not all. See, in broadcasting, you will be sending data to all the nodes, right, of given network. But in multicasting, you cannot send data to all the node. You will be sending data to multiple nodes, means group of the nodes, right? Let me explain you that by difference in between multicast and broadcast, that will give you more clarity. So see, here broadcast means what? We are sending data to all the nodes which are there inside given network. But in multicast, what we do? We will be sending data from one node to multiple node, right? But not all nodes. Here, when it comes to packets, then packets are transmitted to all the connected devices inside given network. But with multicast, packets are transmitted to some of the devices in the network. When it comes to group management, then in broadcast, you don't need to do group management. Why? The reason is, you can send data to entire network, right? Those nodes which are there inside entire network, right? While in multicast, we need to have group management, right? Here, when you do group management, in that group only you can forward the message. See, broadcasting is not secure. Why? The reason is, here we are sending data to all the nodes. But multicast is secure. Why? The reason is, here we are sending data along with group management. In broadcast, there will be more traffic. Why? The reason is, one node is sending data to all the nodes. So it will be utilizing all the links probably. It will be utilizing some bandwidth of entire network. With multicast, it will be using less traffic. Why? The reason is, it will be transmitting data to selected nodes of group, right? You'll be observing that broadcasting is slower, right? Why? The reason is, it will be occupying network with higher capacity. And multicast, that will be faster. Why? The reason is, here we are not utilizing entire network, right? So broadcast is happening network wise, and multicast, that is happening group wise, that you can see. Like, for example, when it comes to WhatsApp group, right? So in WhatsApp group, when you send a message, then that will be received by the users which are there inside that WhatsApp group. So that is what? Multicast example. But when it comes to broadcast, that will be like one user is sending data to everyone. Like if WhatsApp is sending data to all the user, right? Then that will be broadcast by WhatsApp. But as if you are managing one group, inside that you will be sending data, then that will be received by users which are there in particular group. That will be multicast, right? So broadcast, that will occupy more bandwidth of network. It will occupy more network's resources, right? Multicast will not occupy entire network. It will be occupying some bandwidth only. Here, multicast is a bit secure compared to broadcast, that you can see. I hope now the basic differences in between unicast, broadcast and multicast, that is clear to you. Still, if anything that you would like to share over here, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.